everyone. Welcome back to Montel. Today we're talking to survivors of unimaginable abuse. We're gonna hear Janice's story in 1 second. First, I just want to say something. As you may or may not already know, I am a very vocal advocate for the legalization of medical marijuana. I think if used appropriately and responsibly, it can help a whole lot of people. Blah, 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 blah. That being said, I want to pass around this petition, please. Just sign it, pass it on your left-hand side. That'd be great. Really appreciate that. On to Janice. Janice.
Hi, Montel.
Janice, 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 Janice. Janice, what happened to you? You know, let's start at the beginning. You're living in Kansas City.
That's right, Montel. I was waitressing in Kansas City when I married my husband, Hal, in September of 87, but the abuse didn't start until...
Now, I don't know. I don't know if you people... I don't know if you can really begin to understand what this... I mean, I have never... I can't imagine why someone would want to abuse... It's not part of my mentality. I don't understand how this person took another person. Sorry, and if you... I just don't understand how it... Tell us what happened. Tell us what happened.
Okay, well, in about October of 1988...
Wow.
About October of 1988, my husband began to physically and emotionally abuse me. And...
Wow. Wow. Wow, that is some good stuff. That is... Whoo! That is some good stuff. Your courage. Your courage. That is some dank, chronic courage. That's what that is. Wow. Oh, yeah. What? I don't think any of us can fully understand what it would be like to be abused by your boss.
Husband.
Husband. That's what it says on this card. That's what it says right here. This abuse went on for 1 year, 2 years, 3 years.
2 years.
2 years. That's what I said. That's what I said. All right. I'm good. I'm good.
I'm dizzy.
All right, now. Now, Maria.
Janice.
Just tell me what happened next? What happened next? What happened? What happened next? What happened? What happened next?
I'm having a hard time remembering.
It's all right, take your time. Take your time. Take your time. It's hard. It's hard. It's hard talking about this kind of thing.
Right. He would tie me up to the dog and take me into the basement.
I'm sorry. I don't know what's funny. That's not funny at all. That's not funny. Whoa. All right. But you said, go on with your story.
Well, he would tie me up to the dog and...
That's it. It's the tying up to the dog. That's absurd. That's ridiculous.
He would leave me there, and there was one time that the only food I had to eat was a piece of cheese from a mousetrap, and I had to fight a mouse for a piece of cheese one time. Well, I was fighting the mouse for a piece of cheese.
That's it. All right, wait. You're tied to a dog, and you're eating mouse food. What the f***? All right, forget it. All right, you know what? Janice, hello. You're down there. You're hungry. Are you hungry? Were you hungry? Are you hungry?
Now, no.
Well, that's more for me right there. That's what that is. All right.
That's it. I saved myself by being able to...
You know, I don't know. I want to stop you right now. I want to break it down real quick with a real serious question.
Are those ribs?
Mm. Have you ever... Yes, they are. Have you ever looked at a picture of an elephant or ostrich or something and just thought, wow, that could be what an alien looks like. That could be like... Man could totally be, well, like a creature from another dimension, or it comes through a portal, looks like. We don't know. You know what I mean? We have absolutely no idea of that.
What does that have to do with my situation?
Actually, I'm glad you asked that question. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dr. Bongenstein. Doctor. Oh, yeah. Oh, ain't that the truth? Oh, gadzooks, yes. Okay, we're about to hit this up. What was that? What was that?
I didn't hear anything. I don't know what you're hearing. I don't hear a thing.
No, you heard a sound. There was a wicker drum. It's not, no, no, no.
I don't even know what that is.
You're not listening. Listen, it's a bop and get cat.
I'm trying so hard.
All right, well, that is freaking me out. Oh, hello. Oh, my. Oh, this is not cool. This is some trippy stuff right here, bro. This is the one right here, bro. Yeah, that's it. Oh, wait. Oh, I hear it. Oh, thank you. Can't see it. Can't see it. Oh, look. Dimensional travels right here. All right. Well, it remains consistent. Interdimensional travel and the space-time continuum will not break. That's what we have figured out on this show. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for coming to the show. Good night.